lecture, we continue our discussion on counters. If you recall, in the last lecture, we talked about the design of binary ripple counters, both up counting and down counting modes, where the counters were counting modulo some power of 2. If it was a 3 bit counter, it was modulo 8. Modulo 8 means it counts from 0 to 7 and back to 0. Modulo means divide by 8 and take the remainder. So, it will go up to 0 to 7. Modulo 16 for a 4 bit counter, 0 to 15 and then back to 0 and so on. Now, in this lecture, to start with, we shall be discussing the design of arbitrary modulo counters, not necessarily to the power of 2. Okay? So, in the second part of counter design, we start with the design of binary ripple counter of arbitrary modulus. So, what do you mean by arbitrary modulus? We are saying that in general, we are trying to design a modulo m counter for any value of m. Let us say m is 6. So, if we have this kind of a scenario, then the counter will count from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3 up to m minus 1 and then again back to 0. So, as I said, modulo m means divide by m and take the remainder. So, if m equal to 6, I am saying number of pulses that have come divided by 6 and take the remainder. So, the value will be something from 0 to 5. That will be the final value in the counter, right. Now, let us look at the general design principle for such a counter. Now, we make some assumptions here, based on that we arrive at the design. The first thing is that we are trying to design an up counter. Down counter can be designed in a very similar way, but for the time being we are assuming that it is an up counter. It will count in the upward direction 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to m minus 1. Now, we are assuming that the flip flops have individual asynchronous clear inputs, which is active low, which means if the clear input is set to 0, all the flip flops will be reset to 0. The idea is very simple. I do not want the counter to go to m. After m minus 1, I want it to come back to 0. So, whenever it tries to reach m, I will forcibly bring the counter to 0, I will clear the flip flops. The idea is that mod 6 counter 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as soon as it tries to become 6, I will activate the clear inputs, they will all become 0 again. Okay? This is the basic idea. Now, the first thing is that for a modulo m counter, we need log m number of flip flops. Ceiling means the smallest integer that is greater than or equal to this number. Let us say if m equal to 6, log m will be how much? Log n will be 2 point something. So, ceiling will be 3. So, I will be needing 3 flip flops. Let us take m equal to 14, then log m to the base 2 will be 3 point something. So, ceiling of that will be 4. I would need 4 flip flops. So, here you take a decision how many flip flops are required. Then we use a simple gating circuit, a simple circuit I shall show you how to design it, which will take inputs from the counter outputs and it will generate a 0 in the output whenever the count value reaches m. That means, I will not allow the counter to reach m. I will make the counter 0 immediately. So, whenever the output of this gating circuit is 0, that is connected to the clear inputs of the flip flop will become 0 again. So, let us take an example of a modulo 6 counter, how to design it. So, for 6, the number of flip flops as I said will be equal to 3, log 6 to the base 2 will be 2 point something. Ceiling will be the next higher integer 3. Now, for a mod 6 counter, we want the counter to count in this sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then back to 0, which means I am not allowing the natural next count, which is 6, 1, 1, 0 to come. So, whenever it tries to become 1, 1, 0, I will forcibly make it 0 again. So, how do I do it? This is what I mentioned. It can be done very simply like this. You see, you just ignore this NAND gate for the time being. The first 3 flip flop is just like a modulo 8 counter. 3 flip flops, where the output of a flip flop is feeding the clock input of the next flip flop, active low triggered. Now, what this NAND gate is doing? NAND gate is trying to look for whether the count is reaching 110 or not. 110 means what? This is 1, this is 1 and this is 0. So, you look at the 1s. The outputs which are supposed to be 1 in this invalid state, you feed them as the input of this NAND gate. So, whenever these 2 bits are trying to become 1, 1, the output of the NAND gate will become 0 and the 0 will immediately clear the flip flops. So, the idea is that when you are in state 1, 0, 1, suppose you are in state 1, 0, 1 and you apply a clock, it will temporarily go to 1, 1, 0 and immediately the counter will get cleared. This 110 will be a temporary state, right? This is how we can design such a counter with arbitrary modulus, right? Okay. Now, let us work out for a divide by 6 counter as I have seen here. Now, whenever there is 110, it will get cleared. Just you remember this thing, whenever the count value will be 110, it will be immediately cleared to 000. Now, let us look at this Q 0. Q 0 will be going on changing at every falling edge. There is no issue with Q 0. Let us start with all 0. So, we have 0, 0, 0. So, the first clock comes, it becomes 0, 0, 1. Next clock comes, there is a falling edge, this will change state, it becomes 0, 1, 0, 2. Next clock edge comes, this will continue 0, 1, 1, which is 3. Next clock edge comes, there is again a falling edge, this will change again 4. So, this will be 1, 0, 0, this will become 4, then again there is a falling edge here, this will not change, this will also not change, 1, 0, 1, this is 5. Now, here temporarily it will try to become 6, because there is a falling edge here, it will go up. This is already high, so it is 1, 1, 0, but as soon as it tries to go up, the counter will be reset, it will become 0, right. So, it will become 0, 0, 0 again and this will continue 0, 0, 0 again in the next clock. it will become 001. Again it will become 010 and so on, right. Now, the point to note is that if you look at the Q2 output, you see it is starting from 0, it is going up here, it is again going down here. So, how many clock pulses are required? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, after every 6 clock pulses, this Q2 is completing one pulse, which means I can say in Q2 the frequency will get divided by 6. So, the basic observation is any mod m counter that we design, if we take the last output, in this case Q2. So, the input frequency will get divided by 2 to the power m, not 2 to the power m, input frequency will be divided by m, it is a modulo m counter. In this case it was mod 6 counter, the frequency was getting divided by 6, right. This timing diagram also shows that, ok. Let us continue. Let us now look at a very widely used kind of a modem counter, which is mod 10. This is also called a decade counter. Decade is nothing but 10. This is sometimes called a decade counter. Now, if m equal to 10, if you take log 10 to the base 2 and ceiling of it, it will be 3 point something. So, this is 4. You need 4 flip flops. And 10 is what? 10 is 1010. So, whenever you try to reach 1010, you must reset it to 0. 1010 means 1010. So, Q3 and Q1 are trying to become 1. So, in this NAND gate, you will have to connect the output Q3 and connect the output Q1. And the output of this NAND gate, you will have to connect to the clear input. This will make you a decade counter. So, just by selectively connecting the outputs to this NAND gate, you can design any arbitrary mod M counter. In this case, I required mod 10. So, I connected the outputs corresponding to the number 10, 1010, 1010. 1 is here, 1 is here, I connect it like this. So, I get a mod 10 counter. Right, simple, ok. Now, next point is how do I cascade counters and what will happen if I cascade two counters? Cascading counter means connecting them like this. Suppose I have a mod M counter. The last means the most significant bit, that is connected to the input clock of the next counter. If I have a mod M counter or a mod N counter, the point to remember is that you already know, I have shown for a mod 6 counter, that if I have a mod M counter, if my input clock has a frequency f, then in the most significant bit output, the frequency will get divided by m. But if this signal is now fed to the clock of another counter mod n, this will also do a frequency division by n. So, in the final output, the frequency will be divided by m n. So, you should remember this. If counters are cascaded, then the modulo will be the product of the individual modulus. Mod m, mod n, if you connect them in a cascade, it will become mod m n. Modulo M N counter, right. Now, this principle can be used in the design of arbitrary kind of counters. Let us take some specific examples. Let us see, I want a modulo 1000 counter. Like, we have so many kind of equipments where some digits are being displayed in decimal, like a frequency counter or any kind of digital displays. numbers are normally displayed in decimal. So, how do I implement a 3-digit counter in that case? Because numbers are in decimal 0 to 9 and then again back to 0. Suppose in a 3-digit, I need a modulo 1000 counter. So, what I do, we use 3 mod 10 counters, mod 10. Well, here I am showing from the other side. Suppose my input clock is coming like this, mod 10 counter will be having 4 outputs. Suppose this is the most significant bit, this is MSB. This MSB is connected to the clock of this, this is again MSB, this is connected to the clock of this. So, if I have a circuit like this, then this will be a modulo 1000 counter where you are counting in decimal. That means, this is a, you can say this is a BCD counter, because each of the stages will be counting from 0 to 9 and then again back to 0, 0 to 9, 0 to 9. So, this is a binary coded decimal BCD counter, this is not a binary 1000, okay? This is BCD 1000 counter. Now, if I want to display them in digit, what I can do, you know BCD to 7 segment decoder we discussed earlier. So, you can use that kind of a decoder circuit here. BCD to 7 segment decoder. So, you have this kind of a circuit, and this decoder circuit you can use to drive some 7 segment display units. So, in this way you can have a 3-digit display where it will be counting the number of clock pulses in decimal, right. This kind of an application is quite common in many equipments, you have this kind of a circuit. Internally they are implemented like this. There are a number of decade counters. Decade counters are actually counting in BCD essentially, they are cascaded together and you can directly drive the digits, right. So, this is one example. Let us take another very interesting example which you see everywhere, a digital clock. Now, in a digital clock, first let us see what kind of output we get. We have 2 digits that indicate hour, 2 digits that indicate minute, and again 2 digits that indicate seconds. But the point to note is that the way this counting goes on are not the same for the 3 different parts. In second, you are counting from 0 to 59 and then back to 0, which means it is a mod 60 counter. For minute also you are counting from 0 to 59, this is also a mod 60 counter. An hour, let us assume that it is a 24 hour format, so it will count from 0 to 23, it will be a mod 24 counter. And again, because the numbers are all displayed in decimal, they will have to be designed using decade counter or BCD counters only, because we want the display in decimal, not in binary. This is the basic requirement, right. So, to do this, what we have is that basically I will be using a cascade of 3 counters, as I had said. So, again I am showing from the right side. First modulo 60, then modulo 60, then modulo 24. Now, in the input, I am applying a 1 hertz clock. 1 hertz clock means 1 pulse every second. It will be counting the number of seconds. So, this output will give you seconds. This output will give you minutes. And this output will give you hours. This is the overall block diagram that it is. So, I need to design mod 60 counters, 2 of them. I need to design a mod 24 counter, one of this. Let us see how I can design these counters separately. First, we talk about modulo 60 counter design. Because you are designing using BCD. So, what we do? You use a mod 10 counter and a mod 6 counter. You see, I need 60. So, if you multiply 10 by 6, it becomes 60. So, I said mod m and mod n counter, if you cascade together, it will become mod m n. So, I require mod 60. I take a mod 10, I take a mod 6, because 10 into 6 is 60. This will serve my purpose. So, I connect them in cascade. Connect them in cascade and basically, if this mod 10 has 4 outputs, the most significant bit is connected here. And mod 10 will be fed with the input clock. Mod 6 will also be having 4 outputs. And here I will be using this BCD to 7 segment decoder circuit. And to the output of it, one digit will come here, and to the output of it, one digit will come here. So, the mod 60 counter I can design like this, mod 60 module. So, this will be a mod 60 counter, this will be driven by these are BCD to 7 segment decoder driver. And finally, they will be driving the 7 segment displays, right. So, I will be requiring 2 such mod 60 counters. Then I need a mod 24 counter. So, how do I design a mod 24 counter? Because you see mod 24 is an odd number, I cannot generate 24 by multiplying 10 with something. Okay. So, I will take the next higher. So, what do I do? I take a mod 10 counter. You see, I have to use mod 10 because I am counting in decimal. And next one, I take mod 3. So, it becomes mod 30, okay? mod 3. Next higher. And the input clock is coming here, mod 10. The most significant bit is fed as here. And this will be mod 3, 4 bit output I am generating. Now, on this part, this side it is similar, BCD to 7 segment decoder driver and 2 displays. Now, the point to note is that I need a mod 24 counter, but this is a mod 30 counter. Okay? Now, 24 means what? If you write down the number 24 in binary, 24 means 16 plus 8 means 1000 is 8 and 0001 is 16. This is 24. Okay. So, you see in 24 these 2 bits are 1. So, again similarly I use a NAND gate. Most significant bit of the first stage, which is this. This I connect as one of the input, and least significant bit of the next one. This one. And this I use to connect to the clear input of all the flip flops, clear bar, clear bar. So, whenever it becomes 24, I reset it to 0. So, this will be counting from 0 to 23, right. So, in this way I can design a mod 24 counter. So, you see in this way I can design arbitrary counters, and for many practical applications as I have shown, I need to count in decimal so that I can display the results in decimal. I need decade counters or BCD counters, they are also sometimes called for this purpose. So, I have taken two examples of a mod 1000 counter and also that of a digital clock, which is very common, to illustrate this process. Okay. So, with this we come to the end of our discussion on the registers and counters. Now, I re-emphasize registers and counters are very important building blocks in system design. Whenever you design complex systems, you need to design registers, you need to use counters. Depending on the situation, you will have to design a register or a counter with a specific functionality. Based on whatever we have discussed, I believe you will now be in a position to design any kind of a register or counter as per the requirement or the need. Thank you.